much different.
Okay.
Much different. It's much, yeah, this is the one to go. This is the best of this model. There will be no better model.
Here's a Toyota Supra engine running. Can you fit, I'm just going to give it some gas. Go ahead. Okay, you can let it idle. And just gun it a few times, just wrap it a couple times.
Okay.
Do it a couple times. Okay, that's good.
Here we are test driving the 92 Toyota Supra.
Okay.
In a Ferrari.
Oh my god. Okay. Let's go left. There's an area there that's a little bit open. Okay. Good.
Okay.
First for you, I'm gonna try to shift it before the rev limiter this time.
Turn off the air conditioner, is that what you
want
to do?
Okay, go. Punch it. Oh. Okay.
Alright.
Yeah, that's awesome. It's pretty quick.
Yeah, just get some air, just some outside air.
Outside air?
Yeah, just so you don't run.
You go like this. You go like this.
You want this on.
And then this is.
Yeah, you want outside air and then just give it some fan, I guess, right?
Right.
And then we'll get as cold as we can get it.
Okay, sure. And go straight because that's a gated community there.
Can I make another UE?
Yeah.
Go back and let me do that.
Yeah, you can make a UE. But, you know, these are low boost, big, upgradable, but... Oh, no, you're not. Are you pressing it all the way?
I thought I was. Okay. Try it again.
Yeah. That's...
So before we go down too far, like turn around. I don't want to go on the main.
These are 500 horsepower engines, but you have to upgrade some parts to make it really. Yeah, shifting a little earlier, I think, on the low gear. You have to put it in the first to hold it longer. See how the pole starts pulling in higher gears?
All right.
You have to hold the gear. You're going to have to put it back into L and do it.
Let me do one more time. Now I'll be pushing.
Okay. Oh, let me do this. Is the power light on now?
It's got ECT power.
Light is on.
Okay, now it's on. Okay. Downpipe. It's because it's got all the old factory cat exhaust pipe, and the gas is probably like I haven't put a. I always try to leave it low because I want to put fresh gas in it and shift it manually, or I can shift it for you. now you're going uphill, so it's going to be a little different.
Oh, you're gonna miss.
Yeah, that's the rev limiter.
Is that original equipment?
Yeah. Okay.
Shift.
Well, we gotta slow down. It's a stop sign here. That's enough. I think I had it. That's all.
Oh, you just keep it so I can.
Seems like that the shifting got better after we drove it a while. Like in the beginning, it was a little. I guess I had to maybe warm up, or this might be a little dry.
They shift strong. That's how these transmissions are, especially when you go into ECT. I think if you go into the normal mode, it's a little smoother.
Oh, so we were. What mode was that?
They call it the power mode, but you know.
So you had it in power mode just when we were using it?
Yeah.
What is normal? Can we go?
It's just softer shift patterns. Quicker shift.
Yeah.
But no. No more fast driving on it.
No, I know. But I mean, okay. So.
Because I'm already getting like a heart pounding here.
Yeah, I understand. Yeah, but I mean so the power shift was the harder shifts, and then the normal shifts is.
Yeah, it's a little bit smoother. It shifts.
Noises.
What noises?
Bass drum.
Try another station.
Coming from that speaker's going bad.
That's weird.
Yeah.
I never did that before.
All I did was turn the station, man.
Yeah. It just happened. Yeah. What is that from?
Maybe the speaker's going bad. Or
Turn it off and let's see what happens if you. Okay. So stop at least. And then what happens when you turn it back on? That is funny. Yeah, that's a decent thing.
Okay, yeah. It's no big deal.
So I guess that speaker is not working.